Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to install Oracle 19c and SQL Developer on Windows. So on the Google, we're going to search for Oracle 19c for Windows. The first link over here, we're going to click on that. We are in the Oracle website. In order to download this file, which is a zip file about 2 GB of memory, the best thing is to start to create an account first. So if you have an account, you can just log in, or if you don't, you can create an account over here. Click on the create account. In this page, it's going to ask you a few questions regarding email address, password, and a few other questions. Just fill up the application and create an account. I already have an account, so I'm going to click on sign in. So I'm going to click download. It's going to ask you a license agreement, check mark, and download. And it starts downloading right now. All right, so the file has been downloaded. We're gonna right click on that and extract the file and extract it over here. So the folder has been extracted. We're going to double click on the folder and we're going to scroll down all the way to the end, which is a setup.exe. Double click on that, asking for permission, yes, and quickly it's going to open the window in order to start installation. Now we're going to use the default settings as they are here to create and configure a single instance database. Click on next. You're going to use the desktop class, next. And this is the first time we're going to use it, so we're going to create a new Windows user, just a user CySyst, and create a password as you like. Remember to use it for next time. Confirm it and click next. You can just change the folder wherever you like it. We can leave it as it is, or we can go ahead and do the browse and change it. Okay, and now we're gonna create a password. We can use the same password that has used it before. Retype it again. Click next and it's because of the weak password, so we can just pass it by yes. And we're going to leave the installation as default, so we're going to check install. The installation successfully finished. We can close it. Now we're going to type sys as sysdba, and the password that you have it. So as we see that we are connected to the SQL. Now we're going to go back to the Google, and we're going to look for SQL Developer download, and we can scroll down to find in Oracle website. Click on this. I have a 64-bit Windows, and if in case you have different type of operating system, you can choose what is suited for your device. So click on download and check mark over here for license agreement, and click download. So downloading the SQL developer is finished, and we're gonna right click on that, and it's a zip file. Okay, so it's been extracted. The only thing we're gonna open this folder, and as you see, it doesn't have any kind of installation. It's already been it's ready to use basically. So we're gonna cut it from here, and I'm gonna take it and put it in the same folder which I created on my C drive, and I'm just gonna paste it right there. Now we're gonna double click on the SQL developer folder, and we're gonna go all the way down to get to the SQL developer file and double click on that. Now the browser is ready to use, initializing, and this is the interface of the Oracle SQL developer. Now we are going to make our first connection to the database. I'm going to create a database called MyDB, and I'm going to create it. Role is going to be sysdba, and the username sys, and the password as you chose at the beginning of the installation. I'm going to change this one to sit to ORCL, and we're going to test the connection, which is successfully tested, and we're going to hit the connect. We're going to right click on the tables, create a new table, call it parts, and the first column is going to be ID, and that's going to be numbers. And next column is going to be part name, string, and then next one is going to be as part number, and we're going to keep that as number. Okay, this is going to be our table. The table is created, and now we are going to insert some data into our database. So it's going to be ID, part name, part number, and the values are going to be 1, and the part number 200, and we are going to run this statement. One row is inserted, and we're going to change this to 2. Run it again. For instead of mirror, we're going to put it as headlight, and the item number is going to be 230. run this statement again, and we inserted one more row, and the last time we're gonna add one more line, and we're gonna call this one with backlight, and the item number is 400. Now we inserted three rows into our parts table. We're going to run select everything from parts semicolon and run the statement. And now over here we're going to see we have our table has three rows, and with the values that is being stored in it. I hope this tutorial has been useful, and I hope you learned something from this tutorial, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.